Hi everyone, Pete Coleman here. I hope you are having an awesome day. So in today's video, I would like to show you how you can match up your PCB inside of the housing that you've chosen. So in our previous video, which I will link down here in the comments below, we have made our PCB board outline. The question now is, if we have this outline, we want to make sure that it fits our housing. I've had it happen a couple of times before that I made a PCB. The PCBs were assembled. The moment I received them, I tried to fit them in my housing and it didn't fit. So today, there's no excuses anymore to make these mistakes. There's all these kind of nice tools that exist to make sure that everything matches up. So today, I'm going to show you exactly that, how you can make sure that your PCB matches up your housing without having any of these on your table today. So I hope you enjoy this video. Let's dive into it. Now, a second interesting thing to check here is to use the 3D step module as well to see if it really fits nicely in between. So let's go ahead and add that. Replace the 3D body. I have already downloaded that. And let's see if this is oriented as it should. It's already on the good place. Okay, we can leave it like this. So if we try to match these two, what you see now is that the PCB is somewhere inside, but of course you want to see what is happening. So we can alter the transparency or the opacity of this one. So what you see now is that the holes are not exactly matched with the casing. So that's something that should be fixed. And then if you look right here on the side, it's maybe a bit difficult to see. The board should be placed a bit lower as well. So let's go ahead and select this one, the standoff height, maybe -2 millimeters. Then the board is quite small defined as well. So like this. Now the next thing we want to check is if there's nice clearance here, and this looks okay. This looks okay as well. The only thing that I'm not sure of is how these holes match up over here. So you see that this is not correct. So I'm going to use zero rotation to be 100% sure. Then what you can do is draw it a bit up so that it matches. For that, the grid needs to be even smaller. So in this way, we are matching up these holes. And what I would do here, or what I would suggest, is to make these holes bigger than what they are now. Because you see over here, it's not an exact match. It looks a-okay, but it's not exact. So what I would assume there, or what I would propose there, is that you just make these holes a bit bigger than these cutouts, so that there is some more clearance. So the 2.5 is defined. It might be interesting that you make it 2.7 to have some extra clearance. But over here, that's a tight but a correct fit. And over here, same thing, it's a tight fit. But it's just correct. You can shift it a bit. So in this way, we have drawn, in no time, we have drawn our PCB outline with the correct holes, correct sizing. If you do that manually, this will take you some time with the cornering and stuff. If you just use the DXF, you have the exact footprint or outline that you need. And then we verified using the 3D module that is provided by the manufacturer as well. So a very nice, interesting way to quickly do that.